and we're going to go down. Keep your backs nice and flat. There you go. Now reach side to side. And as you reach side to side, it's very important that you bend your knees. Good. And stretch. Feel a nice stretch in through the inner and outer thigh region. Reach. Down, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I want you to keep moving from side to side. Place your hands on your knees. Okay. There you go. Stretch out those legs. Hands are on your knees. Backs are nice and flat still. Okay, this is what I want you to do. You're not pushing back on your knees. You're simply resting your hands there, feeling a nice stretch in through the backs of your legs. Stretch and stretch and stretch. Count down, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I want you to straighten out your legs with the knees slightly bent. Roll up. And I want you to reach up as high as you can and bring your arms down. Just down by your sides. Cross them. Take them up again. Stretch. Stretch right and left. And right, left, right, left. Now let's hold it. Right. 2, 3, 4, 5. Left. 4, 3, 2, 1. Arms come down. Walk your feet in. Hands on your waist. Let's start our march. Big deep breaths. Remember this tune? Okay. It's one of our older tunes. Still a good one, though. Very motivational. Let's place our hands by our sides and do some shoulder rotations with our chins on our chests as our legs march. Okay, and forward. Some nice shoulder rotations, very relaxed. Okay, good. Now place our hands on our waists. Take our right ear over to our right side. Left ear over to our left. And as you know, this tune is going to pick up momentarily. And that's when we're going to branch off to beginner and intermediate. Think about how you're feeling today. The main thing is that you're up and exercising, you're trying, okay? Do whichever level you best feel suits your fitness needs. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I want you to just lightly kick forward. Beginners are doing their own level. They do non-impact aerobics. Stretch those feet out as you go around the room. Good. Bend your knees. Very important. Don't lock those knees. And relax. It's very important that if you are just beginning with our program, that you have checked with your doctor to ensure that your health is good enough to be exercising. Just check. Play it safe. There you go. I'm sure he'll tell you you're fine. Kick and kick. Keep kicking. Do what you can. Very relaxed movements. Gradually increasing the heart rate. And we're going to gradually decrease it as well. I'll take care of you. Count down to arms. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Arms out and cross. Keeping our palms down. Right over left, left over right. Use those shoulders. Okay, good. Nothing to it. Keep the legs in line. Take care in how you're landing. Avoid landing on the balls of your feet. That's right. Countdown to change. Valerie would like us to embed wood too. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Kicking out to the side. Hands on your waist. Kick out. And bring it up. Very relaxed while you exercise. Don't get tense in the shoulders. Relax those shoulders. That's right. Relax your fingertips on your waist. Beginners are stepping and kicking up. Nothing too difficult. And there are variations. Little kicks. Or make them larger. Count down to arms. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I want you to cross them behind. Alternate right over left, left over right. Crossing behind, working our triceps, the backs of our arms. Kicking out. There you go, have a look. Keep crossing. Do what you can. Keep crossing. Cross, cross, cross. There you go. Countdown shift. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and something new. Okay, what I'm doing is it's a little leprechaun move. Okay, your foot comes forward and then you go back. Forward, forward, back. Bring your knee up as you go back. There you go. Take a while to get used to the exercise. Have a look. This is about as advanced as we get here. Not to worry. Good. Lift that knee. Take care of your backs too. Nice and flat. Don't arch. Step, step up. There you go. Count down to arms. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I want you to reach and touch that foot. Relax those hands. Good. It's not difficult. Stretch out those palms. Stretch out your shoulder area. No tension allowed. There you go. Count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Jog on the spot. Bring those heels right up to those bottoms. Lean forward a bit. Use your elbows. Got that imaginary track all lined and ready to go? Get ready? Let's go around our imaginary track. Bring those heels up to those bottoms. Around you go, come on. Do what you can. Last time round. Here we go. Find yourselves a spot. Bring those heels right up to your bottom. Again, variations if you can. This is fun. Same thing with the beginner level, there are variations. Beginners are doing something different. They're stepping behind, crossing over, instead of bringing their heels up. Working the same muscle group. There we go. Do what you can. Let's count down to arms. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and one. Reaching up with those arms. And pull down. Reaching forward and pulling down. You've got it. Work your shoulders, biceps, the lats, back area. Reach and pull. Keep those heels going. Good for you. You've got it. Don't stop. Keep going. Not a whole lot of time left. Work hard. Reach and pull. You've got less than 2 minutes left. You're well over half of the way there. Please don't stop. Keep going. Do what you can. Variations. Same thing at the beginning level. Or if you like, you bring your heels right up to those bottoms. Reach at those arms. Count down to 10. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Side to side. Lifting your legs just side to side. Work your inner and outer thigh region. Moms should be doing the beginner level, as this is very hard on the bladder. Side to side. Bend those knees when you land. There you go. And if you're ready, let's count down to arms. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and out and cross. Make sure your arms aren't coming off shoulder height. Have a look. Good. Your form is very good. You're catching on. You're paying attention. That's great. Come on, cross. Again, variations. Same thing at the beginner level. Or lift the leg up. There you go. Work around the room. Do what you can. Reach those arms. Reach. Unreach. Go on. Into our last few seconds. Countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lightly jog in the spot. Keep moving. Whew, keep those knees bending. Locate your pulse rate either in your wrist or in your neck. Don't push too hard. Get an accurate reading. Counting for 10 seconds, beginning now. Okay, stop counting, keep moving. This is our heart rate target zone chart. You people know how to use it. The number that you've just counted, you find it along the side of our chart, and you find your age along the bottom. For example, if you're 30 years old, you should be counting somewhere between 23 and 28 beats for 10 seconds. That is a safe zone to be working within. Of course, if you are a beginner, you will be a little bit lower. We got to give you something to work towards. We're off to a commercial break, and yes, I have an exercise for you. If you'd like to come with me down here, I simply want you to step back, forward, step back. Once more, and if you're ready, down we go. Let's concentrate on the inner and outer thigh region today. Instead of lying on our sides for a change, let's roll down and do it on our backs. Be a little lazy. Roll down, walk your feet in. Let's get rid of those runners. We don't need the extra weight, not today. Okay, beginners are following up above. Everyone bend their knees, and knees come out, and point your toes if you like, out, and take your head back and just relax. This is going to focus on the inner and outer thigh region. Okay. Out and in. That's a problem area for a lot of people. And I know it's one of my problem areas as well. I think I discovered it when I was 12 years old. My little sister and I used to have competitions where we'd shake and see who could shake the most. And she was chubby and I was fairly skinny. But I remember pounding down on my feet and my legs were wobbling in the center. So we decided then when we were 12 that I had fatty inner legs. Stuck with me too. So work hard. It's funny the things that happen to you when you're a child, how you remember them, how you perceive yourself. In and out. And that's something you've got to take into consideration when you're dieting, you know. You may think that you need to lose weight, but in actuality, you may not need to, because physiologically, your body was built to be a specific weight. Okay? And if you're larger bone, you're going to be a little heavier. So before you go on a diet because you think you need to lose weight, make sure that you check with your physician. Okay? I know I would like to be thinner in through the hip area and through the thighs, but I've just come to accept that that's the way I am built. There's nothing I can do about it. All the exercise in the world isn't going to change that. Okay, so accept yourself. And out. Countdown to change the exercise. Let's count down on French. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept, huit, neuf, and dix. I want you to bring your hips up. I want you to place your hands below your bottom. Now the same thing in and out, but I want you to cross over. Aha, right over left, left over right. Now, you'll notice that when you do exercises in this position with your legs fully extended, that puts a lot of pressure on the lower back. So you will never see us doing that here. Not in this position anyhow. Okay. Only safe exercises get to come on the everyday workout. There you go. And cross. Beginners are doing their own level. Out and in. And out and in. Now let's flex our feet. Stretch out those feet. There we go. And cross, and out, and cross. Just take them out as far as is comfortable for you. Okay, and if you like, you can bring your head up and work the muscles in your neck, your traps, or you can take your head back and just relax. For some of you, I know that you get tension into the neck area when you exercise. So keep your heads down, okay? Just relax. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8. 7, 6, and 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now I want you to take your legs apart. Your hands come away from beneath your bottom. Your legs come apart. I want you to concentrate on pushing them down and offer resistance as your arms try to push your legs apart. Okay? Offer a bit of resistance. Push, push. Beginners are doing their own level. They're at a less intense level. Come on, push, push, push. Bring them up now. Come on. Push those knees together. Film shaking a bit. Push, push. See some tension in the arms? There, use those arms. Okay. And now offer resistance in the other direction as you try to take your knees down. See how much stronger you are in that direction? You are, it's true. So we've got to balance that out. Concentrate on pushing. Push. Push. Offer resistance in both directions. Okay, and last time, up. Push up. Don't strain yourselves too much. Just offer a bit of resistance. Push those knees together. Can you feel that? That's good. That's what we want. Okay, now last time. Pushing out. Offer resistance with those arms. There you go. Down. Okay, and bring your knees up. And I want you to place your hands to the side. Your knees come down. I want you to do a simple exercise. Just cross over and back and over and back. We're going to go off to a commercial break. Just keep doing it. Okay, just finish what you were doing there. And now let's do the exercise that the beginners were doing, because that was a more of a stretch for the hip and thigh region. And what they were doing was bending their knees and then alternating, taking their knees one to the center and one to the side. And you'll feel a nice stretch in through your hip area with this. Do you feel that all up the side there? Okay, up through the waistline. Let's take our hands up overhead and feel a nice stretch through our waists as well. Stretch up. And up to the other side. You'll find that I'm doing most of our cool downs now on the floor. We spend so much of our everyday life standing up, but our backs are taking all the pressure. And it is safer to do exercises, stretches down on the floor. And that's why I'm intending to do more on the floor now this year. And come on up to the other side. And this music is the kind of music that just lulls you to sleep. We'll do it once more to the opposite side. Still reach with those fingertips. And under. Stretch the fingertips. Okay, back to the center. Arms come down by your sides. And I want you to walk your feet up. And I want you to point your knees in together like so. And I want you to bring your buttocks up. Feel a nice stretch in through your lower back. Tighten up those muscles. And then relax. And I want you to walk your feet together. And I want you to let your legs fall out into that thigh and groin area that we were just working. And now if you can only bring your legs to here, that's fine. Don't strain on this one. You just take them up, relax them. And then bring them up once again. And down again. Let them fall out, very relaxed. Close your eyes if you like. Just relax. And again, bring them up. And now, clasp your hands in front of your knees. Bring your knees right up for a nice stretch of the lower back area. It's a nice way to start off the day. You feel rejuvenated? I hope so. Down again. And now alternate your knees. If you'd like to follow along, I'm going to continue stretching. I'd like to thank you for joining me. My name is Cynthia Kereluk, and I hope to see you again soon. Until then, take care now. Bye-bye.